once I have finished off with what I want, with everything else. So the one thing that I find is a missed opportunity of the original mod is that the creator didn't make two separate versions. Versions, sorry. Two separate versions. One is that it's where it is right now, which is in the normal world space of Tamriel, pretty much. Or a separate one that's in its own world space, which I would have preferred. So there is a house mod. If you don't know this, then it's definitely a house mod I do recommend if you want a really nice looking one. There is a house mod called Aaron Maffey. It's in a similar style as the one that I'm talking about, but it has a different aesthetic. I guess it is something you can say. The thing is that for the Aaron Maffey, it's an alien dungeon. Whereas this one is more of a... Whereas the one that I'm talking about is like an alien city, so it's a bit different. With a palace on top. And for Aaron Maffey, it has two separate versions. Sorry, I bit my tongue, so I'm trying not to like hurt myself even further. So there is the one in which that it is a part of the main Tamriel, and then another one in which that it has its own world space that you can go to. But I think it still has a version of it in Tamriel, but it's expanded upon within its own world space. Which is an amazing thing to have. But I think that the mod that I'm copying things from would have been better if it had its own world space in general. So it has a teleporter in Tamriel. That doesn't need to change. But what it should have done is it should have had its own world space that you go to. Which would have been a much better idea. I shouldn't go out in the water. I don't have any rockets. But yeah, so pretty much I just moved everything one-to-one. I'm still missing a few objects, but these objects are more so just the lighting, so they're like the lighting fixtures, so it's not like I'm missing a lot. And then I just gotta double check to see if everything's actually in their proper spot. Just like I did with a different area within the mod, so that would go. At the end of the day, it'll be done. So I did learn my lesson of the light levels, or not the light levels, but of the cells in general. So I have duplicated all the cells. I've just changed them so that though the duplicates have 0AXM in their name. And then what I got to do is I just got to update the light levels of all of the cells. And some of the cells I find is a missed opportunity for the mod creator to have put them all as one cell instead of creating three cells for one area. Could have put them all as one. And I know that the one I want to do is going to take so long, but it's going to be so worth it too. So the one thing that I want to do is I want to see if I can create, because I don't think it's... Did I ever reveal the castle? Maybe. But the castle that I want to move is Castle Anvil. There was a mod that I downloaded called Open Cities Reborn, I think. And I like their look of two castles. I like their look of the Anvil Castle and the... Was it Anvil Castle and the Stingray Castle? I like both of them. But between the two of them, I preferred the Anvil Castle because I love Anvil. Although their Anvil Castle had a little bit of extra features, which I didn't like, but I could easily just delete those. So it's not that big of a deal. Anyway. So that's exactly what I did. I didn't delete the features, but like... I don't think some of them transferred over, which was really weird. Anyway. The only thing that I did do was that I moved some things around and yeah. I don't think I did anything else, did I? Yeah, so the original mod is the same as it is. Or the version that I'm working on is the same as the original. The only thing is that, like, I changed some of the things to be 0AXM instead. So that at the very least, they're all ready to go, specifically for the conversion. I just gotta change the lair, the hideout, and their subsequent, like, objects that they're gonna be using to also be 0AXM. So that at the very least, I can move them back into the original mod, but just make them so that they're inaccessible. Until those areas are finished. I'm going to try and make the hideout. Not just the hideout. I'm also going to try and make it so though the... So the hideout, I might be able to move it to 2 cells maybe instead of 3. Depending on how I want to do the ship part. The captain's cabin area I can't do anything about. Because of how it is, so I can't really do anything about that, unfortunately. But for everything else, I think I can do something about it. Again, I gotta plan around for the bottle ship part first. I've already kind of moved everything for the bottle ship, so it's all ready to go. I just gotta do it, pretty much. And I gotta change how the sigil stones are how their editor ID is again for a second time. Again, they were originally AXM, and then when I changed it to 0AXM, I had to do it all over again. So now I got to do it again, so that they're sorted between their the original vanilla ones and the DLC ones. So hooray! Other than that, I don't think there's anything else. Yeah, I don't think there's anything else. It's mostly just get lair and hideout finished and ready to go, so that way I can start actually using those areas. And then for the lodge, it'll have its own version, and then the castle will have its own version, and then we don't have to worry about anything anymore. The only thing is that the Lodge version might not have the companion, though. Which will be the only sad thing. Unless I find out what makes the companion, and then I can move it over to the Lodge. Which actually I could do, because I could have it so though I merge the companion with both the castle and the Lodge, but just not do anything with them. Yeah, I think I can do it that way. It's not like it's going to break anything. It's just going to be really weird. Yeah, because the companion, I just want Tess for now. And for everything else, I just want to have the character specifically just to flourish the area, sort of to build up that, just to sort of like make it more lively or busy. Similar to how I'm planning out the Minecraft 1.21 base, where I want to have like all the bees that I've ever collected to be out flying around the cherry tree, so though it's, for lack of a better word, just a buzzing, pretty much. So similar to that, also it, I don't want to say it flexes my creation, construction set knowledge, but like it also allows me to sort of build up the repertoire where I can say, hey, yeah, I built some NPCs. But yeah, while most of it is just, like it was already there, but still. As I said, I would love to be able to reveal more information about it. But as I said about other stuff, though, it's like, it's still planned. It's not like it's going to be a final thing. It's... Because I don't want to get... Like, I don't want to say... I don't want to get, like, everybody's hopes up that, like, oh, yeah, he's going to do it. It's going to be awesome. Because it's happened so many times in Minecraft, too, where, like, I'll be building something, and then later on, I'll be like, I don't feel like building it anymore. And then I'll trash it. Or I'll say, I'll build it later, but yet I'll never remember that I said I was going to build it later. That's why I'm not trying to get anybody's hopes up, but, like, I definitely do want Lair and Hideout to be done. So that at the very least, though, like, since they're going to be finished, it's going to be awesome. However, again, I don't want to get anybody's hopes up. Just trying to make sure that it's easier for me to go through all the nonsense, pretty much. Yeah, but it's going to be a lot of fun just trying to get the companion to work. I gotta get a lot more help on trying to get the companion to, at the very least, to work. Since this will be, like, the first companion I've ever made, so... Or even that I've ever worked on, to be fair, so... It's not the companion has to be perfect, but the companion has to at least work. And then, as I said before, in case nobody was there for that session or something like that, we finally found one! Oh my word. We found one. There he is! But yeah, like, for, what was it, the... For my mod in general, I wanted to create the main mod as the ESM, and then later on we build like subsequent smaller mods that need my mod as the base, or similar to how most mods require Oblivion ESM. All of the ones that I create will require my mod as the basis if they need to. So like the leveled equipment, I need my mod. If I want to use, like, the extra companions, I need my mod. And this one was just going to be more so, like, just, like, OBSC Injection. Or it was going to have, like, my mod's name, but OBSC Injection. So, though, at the very least, it just injects, like, OBSC functionality into my mod. So, like, it allows, like, my armor to auto-repair itself. It allows the hood to auto-repair itself. It allows the weapon to auto-recharge itself after usage or something like that. Like, that's the thing that I'm talking about, though. Like, I would love to be able to have that kind of functionality in my mod itself. All right, so that's going to be it for now. Next time, hopefully, Arcanix will be finished. And, yes. So, oh, before I forget, give me a second. I don't know if I said this, and I might have glossed over for the Pokemon DLC segment. But pretty much, you won't be able to see all this stuff until way after, but the Pokemon DLC will go up to until the 24th of September. So up until the 24th of September, so up until the day of its release, or the day that I get to actually play the darn thing, will go all the way up until the 24th, and then after the 24th, we'll continue onward with where the upload schedule left off. So, yeah, so I'll see you guys next time for some more Sercacraft.